Hello everyone and welcome. Today we are taking a look at the long shot, also called a lungo. This is a shot of espresso that has been pulled quite a bit longer than normal. If a regular espresso has a brew ratio of about 1 to 2, meaning for every gram of ground coffee, there's 2 grams of espresso coming out, a long shot of espresso often has a brew ratio of 1 to 3, or sometimes 1 to 4. This creates a noticeably larger cup of espresso, one that is usually a little more watery and bitter from over-extraction. Historically, this had originated out of Italy, and the taste of it was, and still is, enjoyed today. The traditional barista wouldn't do anything special or change the recipe. They would simply let the shot run longer than normal. And this is where some tension begins to arise. As the world of specialty coffee accelerated, the critiques of old school styles and methods came rolling in. People would argue that a long shot was essentially taking a perfectly good espresso, shoving more water through it, and putting it off balance, making it unpleasant and bitter. Of course, this whole discussion depends on what you want from espresso. Those who enjoyed a traditional long shot from their local Italian shop down the road would likely never be convinced by these specialty coffee nerds, and in a way, why should they? They were enjoying a beverage how they wanted it, and that was good enough for them. On the specialty coffee side, they were, of course, idolizing the balanced taste of a well-extracted, thick, and buttery espresso. And that's fair too. They wanted something different, and so for many, the long shot is out of the question when we talk about it in the context of high-quality specialty coffee shops. But do we have to say no to it entirely? The often judgmental nature of specialty coffee has made it hard to revisit topics that the industry looks down on, but not for everyone. There have been many shops and coffee personalities over the past few years who have taken the dive into longshot territory. And there are some interesting attempts that give us a good starting point and direction toward creating a high-quality, flavorful longshot by specialty standards. I would say for most people, they take the approach of a coarser grind. You essentially want the coffee to take longer to extract, since you're pushing more water through. You don't want it to become over-extracted halfway when you haven't reached your desired volume. By grinding more coarse, you decrease the surface area available to the water, and that slows the rate of extraction. You also allow the water to flow more freely as the grounds don't pack together as tight. The goal is to experiment and find the grind that gives you a balanced and flavorful extraction, all while happening over a longer period of time. Another interesting experiment that I saw was from Chris Baca. He was a coffee YouTuber many years ago when I was first getting into specialty coffee. He now co-owns a coffee shop named Cat and Cloud in California. When they first opened, they were trying out a coarser grind with lower temperatures and lower pressures, around 4 to 6 bars. With these additional changes, they were able to really slow down the rate of extraction, and they were actually attempting to fill entire cups of coffee at the time. I'm not sure how it went or if they still do it, but it certainly gets you thinking about all of the variables that you could play around with and change to slow down the rate of extraction and get longer shots over longer times. Anyway, guys, that's really it for me. This topic wasn't really that complicated, so there's not much else to say. If you want to experiment and play around with long shots by changing the rate of extraction, I think that's great. Go for it. If you want to just leave your shots running longer and you like the taste, I think that's great too. Let me know in the comments what you prefer, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. I will see you all in the next video. Have a great day.